Welcome everybody, it's Gareth Jones here from Paris Technologies. Today we're going to talk about a really interesting subject in FP&A, which is Retail OTB Planning. What does OTB stand for? Open to Buy. It's a really interesting concept used exclusively by retail, and it's quite difficult to calculate. And the reason for that is a very forward-looking metric. It's calculated based on thinking about the future. Now, for planners, we like to do that. We like to get out there in front and be into the future. It's quite hard to calculate this in Excel. Today, I'm going to be using a free version of our technology, PowerExcel, to show you how to do it. And I hope you are able to use what I show you today in your own business. And I hope it's valuable to you and your company. Okay, let's go. So we're talking about retail OTB. Let's think about the basic concept, right? So first of all, you've got a current stock. Let's say you planning by, if we think about stock, we have the SKU, SKU, and maybe there's some different ways of categorizing it. Most common being at the top level, a department, then a category, and then potentially your class, subclass, and SKU. So let's say we're planning at the category level or the class level. We've got a certain store, we've got a certain current stock, and let's say we're in June, and then we know in December we want to have a certain perfect target stock. So how much do we need to buy in order to get to that perfect target stock? Well, the first thing we do is we say, well, okay, let's take our current stock and imagine that we don't buy anything. Then as we sell, the stock is going to fall, right? Makes sense. So let's call that, it gets to a point, we call that the theoretical depleted stock. And then if we compare that theoretical number against this perfect target stock, the difference between them is how much we can buy, and that we will call our open to buy, and the shortcut for that will be OTB. So that's the concept. Now, why it's quite difficult to get this concept right in retail is that it's a very forward-looking metric or very forward-looking concept, right? We need to take our current stock and we need to run it down based on a really accurate sales forecast. And then we need to have a really accurate forecast of what that future target stock should look like. And that target stock in retail very often is expressed as the amount of stock that we need to last the business a certain amount of time, depending on our lead times to get stock into the stores, right? So for example, we might say that we need that stock to last for 3 months. That 3 months worth of stock is what we want. That's our perfect stock, right? And if we express that in weeks, just like very simply, we might say, well, we need 12 weeks of stock. So we should always have 12 weeks of stock on hand. That's the perfect number. So therefore, if you think about it, it's 12 weeks of future sales. So it's quite a difficult concept because we need to plan future sales right out into the distant future. And very often in retail, that can be 24 months, 18 to 24 months at least. All right, let's have a look at a simple calculation for one store in and one class of goods, right? So here we've got four stores. I'm using them some filters here just to display this calculation. North, south, east, west in total. And I've got a whole load of classes, two departments, men's and ladies. And then we've got stuff like men's shirts, men's shorts, and we're going dress shirts, casual shirts, vests. So something like that. And this one, we're looking at sports shorts in the men's department. So if we look at this in a simple way, we've got what we'd expect. We've got sales, we've got cost of sales, we've got gross profit, and you've got your margin percent. Very simple calculation here, just for the example. Then we've got this opening stock in dollars. Then we've got this cost of sales reducing it, and then you've got the purchases increasing it, and then you've got a closing stock. Very simple, no problem at all. Then we've got two new concepts here, FW and TW. And FW, standing for forward weeks, saying, well, how long would this closing stock last before it ran out? And then target, TW being target weeks, we're saying, well, for this particular class of goods, we want to hold 15 weeks of stock. So that's the target. What does that mean in terms of dollars? And as you can see, each time it's a little different, right? Okay. And then the difference then between this closing stock and your target stock is going to be your open to buy. Okay. Nice. Simple concept. However, how do you calculate this? How do you calculate this? Quite difficult, right? Let's have a look at it for you.
Now, what I'm doing here is I'm giving a nice visual display of one store, the North store, and one class of product for 2023. So for each of those, and there could be hundreds of these classifications, especially if you've got a very large product dimension, you need to do 12 calculations for every year. So nice, I've visually shown it to you nicely here. I haven't calculated in Excel, right? So if you look here, there's no formulas. If I delete this in Excel, and then I ask it to recalculate, it just bounces back. So I'm calculating it in a free tool called PowerExcel. It's our tool. I'm doing it in our free version. You can calculate up to 500 categories or up to 500 stores using the free version, single user. It's a very, very powerful engine and it's free. I would really encourage you to use it if you have this type of business and you're not doing it like this yet. It will really help you. Okay, so what is the calculation? So if you have a look at January, we start with the closing stock in January, becomes the opening stock. You've got this cost of sales planned out for a very long period of time, right? So, you know, 24 months or something like that. So that's what you need. You need this long sales planning cycle. That's the critical element to getting this right. And then we come and what we do is we ask ourselves, did the stock last February? Yes. Did the stock last March? Yes. Did it last April? No. So if it lasted February, then February, there's 4 weeks in the year. Did it last March? Yes. There's 5 weeks in March. And then it didn't last April, but it was there in the beginning. So it needs a little portion of April's 4 weeks. Do it as a ratio, you get comma three. If you add those up, let's just take a note of that number, 9.3. And there's your 9.3. Your stock, this 9808, would last 9.3 weeks. The next one is 6.9. It would last only March and then a little bit of April. So there you calculate it, 8.9, return 8.9. So that's how you calculate it. It's a simple calculation. It just has to be done over and over and over again. Let's have a look at the other one. We know our target weeks are 15. So if you think about it, it's got to last 15 weeks. So February, there's 4 weeks. March is 5 weeks, April is 4 weeks. Now this is a typical retail layout. So retail, very typically, not exclusively, but typically they split their months into weeks, 52 weeks in a year, and 12 weeks per quarter, right? To each, 13 weeks, sorry, I think you're right, 13 weeks per quarter. So we need to be able to, so we plan it, 4-4-5, 4-4-5, some retailers have 5-4-4. So we've got that there. So it's kind of nice. So we know how many weeks in a month. And as we go, we accumulate. So we need 15. Well, those first three will get us to 13. Then we need a little bit of May. So there's the cost of sales in February. You include that. There's the cost of sales in March. You include that. Same for April. And then you need a little piece just as a ratio of May. Same here. 15 weeks. So the first three is going to be fine. You add those cost of sales. And then you add a little bit of June. Let's have a quick look. So the target stock there was 14,098. 14,098. And here, 11,302. Each time it's going to be different, especially if you've got a very seasonal business, right? Your target stock's going to change quite a lot. All right. So once we've done this calculation, we get back to here. We've got this idea of the open to buy. As our stock falls below our target stock, we should buy. So we should buy in April, then we find for June, July, and then we should buy again over here. All right, simple to do for one. Let's try a different one. Here I can just change my filtering. I'm just going to go down to, let's go to VES, have a look what that looks like. And I can try a different, this one seems okay, the open to buy has been used up, and try a different store. Try my West store. And I'm changing my filtering and I'm getting the results back. Again, none of this has been calculated. It's just being displayed in Excel. It's been calculated centrally. So very powerful. Okay. I don't really want to be rolling through all the stores and rolling through all the categories. I want a different type of report. So let's think about something like this. A nice exception report, right? Where potentially the controller, my boss, is going to be looking at something like this, and he's going to be able to look at it, and an orange arrow going to the right means everything's perfect. And then I have a green arrow, which means I've got too much stock. And I've got a red arrow, which means I've got too little stock. Why is green too much stock? Why is it green? Well, in retail, you can do something with too much stock. You can, it's going to affect your margin, but it's not going to affect your top line. I'm going to be able to do some promotions. I'm going to be able to do some two-for-ones. I'm going to be able to do discounting. It's going to affect my margin, but I'm going to get the turnover. If I don't have stock, there's nothing I can do. I can't sell what I don't have. So if I've got too little stock, that's my red line, right? So if I'm the controller here and I'm looking, I see, well, I've got most of my stores are fine. I have a problem with this North store. In particular, I've got a problem with the sports shorts class. So let's go and have a look at that one in particular. Let's go to my North store and sports shorts. All right, and let's have a look at this purchases. So again, this is pretty common to have this idea that you've already committed some purchases, and then you've got this planned purchases that you want to plan and prepare for and then place. And it should, once the planned purchases have been committed, they'll move up to this top line. So you can see now I've got open to buy in April, and then I've got it all the way out here. So if I'd missed the lead times here and I had to buy over here, potentially I could add up all of these together. But if I wanted a centralized report, what I could do is I could just close this open to buy. And all it does is tell the calculation, don't consider those months, start here. And you can see it's added it up to this point. So if I do that, I can go 4,300 to 800, 3,600. 700, 300, 100, say, for example, let that recalculate. It's going right out and redoing all of these calculations. Now you can see my target stock's at 15. OTB is perfect. Everything looks good. What does my boss see? He sees that although my stock was low, I've now corrected the problem and I'm fine. I'm going to finish the year perfect. So that's how easy it is to do using this technology. And if you use this technology, it really empowers your buying team and your planning team to get things right. And it can really make a big difference in your retail operations. So if you've got a small store, chain of stores, I would really encourage you to try this free software. If you've got a more complicated business, reach out to me on LinkedIn or look on our website. We've got more powerful paid subscriptions and we've got a team standing by to help you. We've got a lot of experience in this area. And we can make a big difference in your business. Okay, thank you.